Let's say we're given the function f of x is equal to 1 over x squared, and we want to find the area underneath this graph from 1 to infinity. So how would it be possible to write down this number? Would this be a finite number, or would it be an infinite number? Because wouldn't we consider possibly that this area, because this the limit from 1, the upper limit, is going to be infinite, then shouldn't the area be infinite? Let's take a look and do an inspection and see what the mathematics has to tell us. So that this can be represented by the following integral. 1 over x squared from 1 to infinity. But let's consider the integral whenever this is going from 1 to b, where b is some arbitrary limit greater than 1, like so. And then we'll take the limit as b goes to infinity to see if the limit exists. Okay, so then that is if the area converges to a finite value. So let's do the integral from 1 to b, 1 over x squared dx. This is equal to the antiderivative of 1 over x squared is negative 1 over x. So we have negative 1 over x evaluated from 1 to b. This is equal to negative 1 over b minus negative 1 over 1, minus negative 1 over 1. So this is equal to negative 1 over b plus 1. Okay? So that's what this integral, reduces to whenever the limit is b. Now let's let this b go to infinity. Right? And then that will be equal to this. So we can write down the following. Let's write it down this way. Let's say the limit as b goes to infinity of the integral from 1 to b, 1 over x squared dx is equal to, and we're just going to skip these intermediate steps and come to here. So this is the limit as b goes to infinity of negative 1 over b plus 1, like so. Well, whenever b is infinite, the limit of negative 1 over b as b goes to infinity, if this number is really big right here, then this quantity is 0 and the entire quantity is 1. So this limit does exist, it is finite, and the number is 1. So this is equal to 1. These are called improper integrals. That is the name that's been given them. That is the proper nomenclature. And so let's take a look at some generalized statements about improper integrals. So, if f of x is greater than 0 for x greater than or equal to a, so a would be this first limit here, right? Then if the limit as b goes to infinity of this integral from a to b, so in our example, b was here, a was here, so we're integrating this way. If that is equal to a finite element, that is a finite number, a finite quantity, then the limit, then a to infinity, f of x dx, is said to converge. And that it converges to said element, to that element that we just said, that if this is equal to a finite element, if this limit is equal to a finite element, then this thing exists and it converges to that finite element. It's subtle, but there's this thing. Notice the difference between this thing and this thing. This thing is the limit as b goes to infinity, and this goes from a to infinity. It's a subtle mathematical subtlety. Okay, otherwise, the integral is said to diverge. So there will be instances where the integral will diverge. And this is the analog, the description of the argument whenever you're coming from negative infinity, right? Okay, so welcome to improper integrals. So we're going to work a few examples now. I'm going to step out of the way and give you a clear screenshot.